We have new information tonight on the raid on a house in Greenfield last week that left a man dead. 31-year-old Rogelio Serrato died after a SWAT team threw in a flash device into his home where he was hiding. Tonight, the Monterey County Sheriff's Department released new information about what they say led to his death. Action News reporter Stephanie Trong begins our team coverage.
New information released Wednesday reveals there was a second person inside the Greenfield home during last Wednesday's standoff that left 31-year-old Rogelio Serrato dead.
After approximately 20 minutes of hailing the residence, a woman exited the residence. And the woman was asked if anyone else was inside the residence, and she said she didn't believe anyone was still in the house.
The SWAT team continued to operate under the assumption someone was inside. They threw a flashbang device into the home after an hour of trying to convince Serrato to come outside. It sparked a fire.
After the fire was quelled and the smoke began to dissipate, that we realized that Mr. Serrato was still in the residence.
There have been several complaints by neighbors and Serrato's family that the SWAT team didn't immediately enter his home after deploying the device. Sheriff Miller says there's no protocol that requires officers to follow a flashbang device with tactical entry.
The plan here was to deploy this device and then probably, and it's always subject to change, to follow it up with other devices such as tear gas.
We had information at the time that Mr. Serrato had been at the Mucky Duck, and along with a group of other people.
They later learned Serrato had not been there, but with the help of Greenfield police in identifying key players, the sheriff says there was reason to believe Serrato and the suspected gunman, Alejandro Gonzalez, were good friends. A third person of interest was linked to Serrato's home.
And she confirmed that she was with Gonzalez at the Mucky Duck the night the shooting took place.
Investigators also believed the handgun used in the shooting may have been in Serrato's home, but no other details are being released to protect the ongoing investigation. Stephanie Trong, KSPW, Action News 8.
Serrato's preliminary autopsy results indicate he died from smoke inhalation. No signs of any other trauma.